In this lesson, we are going to be looking for shortcuts, or ways to more quickly find derivatives of functions. The first one we're going to look at is derivatives of constant functions. For any constant function, the graph is just a horizontal line, and the tangent line at any point is the same horizontal line. So as you can already see, the slope of that tangent line is always going to be zero. So the derivative of any constant is always going to give you zero. The function x is a diagonal line with a slope of 1. Any point on that diagonal line, the tangent line for that point is also the same line again, and so it's also going to have a slope of 1. So the derivative of x is going to be 1. Now, we found the derivative of x squared previously in another lesson, and we found it to be 2x. We just learned that the derivative of x cubed is 3x squared. And if we work out the algebra here for the derivative of x to the fourth, we're going to find that that's 4x cubed. So hopefully you're noticing a bit of a pattern here. We get x squared becomes 2x to the 1, x cubed becomes 3x squared, x to the fourth becomes 4x cubed. And so we would guess that maybe there's a general pattern of x to some number, the derivative is going to be that number times x raised to one less number. So nx to the n minus 1. It turns out that this is true, and we're going to call it the power rule. Now the thing is, just deciding that there's a pattern is not enough for us to actually know this rule is true. So we need to prove it algebraically. So if we look at the limit as x goes to a, f of x minus f of a over x minus a, that's one of the definitions of the derivative at the point a. And if we apply this to our particular situation, we want to know about x to the n, then we're looking at the limit as x goes to a of x to the n minus a to the n over x minus a. Now we're going to use an algebra fact that x to the n minus a to the n can be factored. And we can factor it as x minus a times x to the n minus 1 plus x to the n minus 2a plus x to the n minus 3a squared plus dot dot dot, and this pattern just keeps going until we get to x a to the n minus 2 plus a to the n minus 1. And this is all over x minus a. But this means that the x minus a's will actually cancel out of top and bottom. So we're left with this big long string of x's and a's. But if we look at it, what this string is, as x approaches a, we get a to the n minus 1 plus a to the n minus 2 times a plus a to the n minus 3 times a squared plus dot 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 plus a times a to the n minus 2 plus a to the n minus 1, replacing all the x's with a's. But notice something now. This is a to the n minus 1. If we multiply these two together, we get a to the n minus 1. If we multiply these two together, we get a to the n minus 1. If we multiply these together, we get a to the n minus 1. And this one's already a to the n minus 1. So it turns out that every term here is going to be a to the n minus 1. So now we have to count and figure out how many of these we have. Well, we started up here with x to the n minus 1, and we ended with x to the 0. So from 0 to n minus 1, that's n terms. So we can simplify this algebraic expression as n times a to the n minus 1, because we're adding together a to the n minus 1 with itself n times. So what we've shown is that the derivative, if f of x is x to the n, then f prime of a is n a to the n minus 1. And so we've shown the power rule is actually true.